shit.
Hello, everybody. 127.
Sure, you want it so high today?
That's better. I think. Waalaikum salam. Assalamualaikum.
Assalamualaikum, everybody. How are you keeping up? We wait for everybody to come in first.
Yeah.
Okay.
Hi Nina.
Alamak, kain pelikat lah. Kata duduk kat rumah. Kenapa pakai sarung, cis?
Hi Tante Diana. Hey Wan, you ma-
hi. Hey Wan, hi.
My God, this is our third week already.
This is our third week, for God's sakes. It's a free concert and you always complain that you always like your schedule doesn't permit you to see our concerts.
It's actually a more of a jam session.
Yeah.
Hi Zaini. Hi Roy. Yen Chet. Oh, there's already about 230 people. Siti. I see Sophia a lot here. Izzuddin. Yeah, so many of you. You know what, guys? Yesterday we had about 4,000.
Really?
4,300 people. 4,400 people.
Are just, you guys telling them about our little
just
secret
like
here?
The night before.
Don't tell them. We don't want too many people because the Wi-Fi is really bad. Okay. So I just found out that the reason why connection is really bad is because there's a damaged submarine cable by Unify. So everybody else piggybacks on Unify. So that's why connection is really bad. So you guys have to just deal with it. We're dealing with it as well, you know.
Apparently, it's going to be going on for like a week.
Yeah, so for them to fix the cable will take a long time, actually. So.
But you know, I actually watched yesterday's live that we saved and it was not too bad, yeah? So, yeah. Most importantly is you're able to hear me properly. It's okay if you can't really see us, you know, because basically there's nothing much to look at anyway.
Yeah,
as you can see, you know, I like to see men in sarong. Yeah.
Shall I do a catwalk here?
but my husband has taken it to another level. He's wearing it every day, all the time, from morning till night, just because I like it. So yep, he's in his kind play card, but I guess it's okay. We're just at home and you know, he's just sitting down. It's not really a show, it's a jam session, because you're gonna see how we're gonna,
hi, Shidi.
You know, like some of our songs, and I'll forget lyrics and he'll forget chords, you know, but it's just for the fun of it anyway. Alright, great. We have more people in here.
They're asking us what do we feel about the extension.
And I was going to announce that afterwards.
Oh, I'm sorry, Zaya. I forgot, this is your show. Okay, I'll keep quiet.
No, we need to do it in stages, okay? Not you guys are going to be like, mula-mula je dah news. Tak happening lah. Mula-mula kita nyanyi dulu, kan? So, like I said, tonight, we're going to be doing a lot more of the old songs. Yeah, and I think you're going to enjoy that. And you can sing along with me. And help me if I forget the lyrics, because it's really long ago, more than like 30 years ago, the songs that we're gonna do tonight. Alright, we're gonna start off with my first hits. 1985. But before I start with this song, I have a little story to tell you. In fact, actually, when they first gave me this song, I just didn't like it. I thought it was like, no way, I'm not singing this song. I wanted to sing songs like what Veena Panduvinata is doing, you know, like really pop with the elements of jazz, and they gave me Pengemis Muda. But eventually they managed to persuade me to do it, because they said that is, you know, it's more a masses kind of song, and people will like it. And you know what? People did. I was quite pleasantly surprised. They liked this song, Pengemis Muda. And so that was my first tape in 1985. Okay, here we go. Sing with me.
Are you ready? Because the intro is very short.
I need to put this away somewhere. Okay, got it. Let's go.
The intro is very short.
Okay. Here we go.
Satu petang ku berjalan, ada menunggu lari memberiku satu notasi yang. Sejak itu ia selalu berdoa manggilku, tak pernah ku peduli.
So you did teleprompter, right?
I need my brains checked or some ginkgo biloba or something like that.
That was fine. That was fine.
Yeah, it's just one of those things where you all of a sudden go blank.
It's okay.
What was it? Just that bayanganmu memburuku, sentiasa berada di depanku, ku tak mengerti tingkah lakumu itu. That's the thing, that's the word I can't remember. And you can't remember the word, you can't remember the verse. But you guys sang for me, right? Okay, thank you.
Okay, shall we just give a clap to her, please, everybody?
Clap to them.
See, everybody's clapping.
So the sound's good, guys?
The sound is good. Everybody says the sound is good.
Visuals, okay. Hi, Chandra.
Hi, Chan.
You guys, you know why? Because today we are back to using my phone.
So that's why you want. Okay. All right. Okay.
Because these past two nights, we've been using Archie's phone. Somehow or other, towards the end, everybody's comments just stopped. You know, so I don't really get to read the comments that you guys send me later. You know, so. That's why I said maybe we try my phone again, okay?
I will go.
Susie. She's always here. Hi.
Hi.
Azman. How are you? Okay, great. Sound is good and visual
Susie
good.
Susie lawa tu rasa tak jadi dia punya ni. Kakak. Kakak Ipa.
So you need to announce it here lah.
Oh, no.
So...
That's
anyway.
What she always says to me. Right?
Okay.
Anyway.
Alright. Alright, so Now we've almost got 500 people. Yeah, see, my phone is better. Hornbill, thank you very much.
Right.
I keep telling him that, you know.
My iPhone 6.
5-star. It's an older model, you know. His is a more new model than mine, but I love my phone. It's so big. It's so big, you know, the screen is so big because, you know, right now, if you notice, I wear watches that's really big because I can't really see. I need a grandfather clock on my wrist, you know. So soon, after this iPhone 6 Plus, I might just need a TV screen.
iPad.
iPad susah taruh dalam handbag.
Taklah, before this life.
Okay. Alright, so... Alright, guys. Hi. Assalamualaikum. We got a lot of more people in now. You know, people, it's... Yanti, Suhaimi, Azura, Hitanayu. Safri, great. Alright, once again, I'd like to say welcome back, guys. You know, okay, let's now talk about the MCO extension. How do I feel about it? Frankly, people, I love this. I love being locked down. Simply because it's great to wake up in the morning. There's no schedules, no appointments, no getting ready, and no having to rush through the traffic, and then, you know, having to look good all at the same time, right? So I'm actually enjoying this because to me, this is luxury, being able to be at home, you know, with my family and with my children. And the best thing about it is they can't go anywhere. They just stuck home with me, and I just love it. So yeah, you know, I get to spend more time with them and do a lot of things that I've been wanting to try and do, or things that I haven't, you know, things that I put left, procrastinate or whatever. So this is the time for me to do it. And I think you guys should also try and find things to do, you know, at least one thing, one productive thing a day would be great, you know, instead of just sitting down and think, you know, you need to think. So yeah, the MCO has been extended for another 2 weeks till 28th April. In fact, actually, the Director General has just said that things are beginning to get just a bit better. So if we still carry on in, you know, staying home and doing what we're supposed to do, you know, hopefully things will get even better. So yeah, so Ramadan is going to be a bit different for us this year. Yeah, there's no more going out to buka puasa anywhere. In fact, actually, I actually don't mind that. Because even when I go out to buka puasa, most of the time for me it's more of a photo session. You know, I don't really get to eat because everybody wants to take photo with me, yeah? And then I prefer to buka puasa at home with my family, and after that we can traweh together. I don't really go to the mosque anymore for traweh because I find that, you know, it's just a rush thing, you know. After buka puasa, you want to go to the bathroom and then you want to do your maghrib, and you know, and then rush because, you know, the time for isha sometimes it varies, kan? And therefore, because of your rush, and then you want to bergaduh with your husband, and your husband will ask to hurry up, you know. And what's the point? You're supposed to go there and do traweh sunat. I'm talking in general.
Okay.
But then you end up fighting. And that's not on, you know. You're not supposed to be fighting, not in the month of Ramadan, and you know, and you need to be sabar. And then you go to the mosque and people are double parking, some are doing 8 raka'at, some are doing, you know, 21 raka'ats. And then you know, you get people who wants to leave early but someone's blocked them and then fight, you know. So I don't know, what is it, you know? You're doing something sunat, but you're so much bigger on doing the sunat than what is the character of an Islamic person, which is to be sabar and be tolerant and not fight and argue and, you know, panas baran, kan? So, yeah, that's my mumijachi for you. So this is what I mean. So I actually like doing my traweh myself at home, where I take my time and not just rush to the mosque. So we can all do that with our family, yeah? So this is the month of goodwill, and we need to appreciate and be grateful with a lot of things that we have, because Some people are not as lucky as we are. Some countries are not as lucky as we are. So we have to always make the best of whatever situation that we're in and whatever we have. Don't complain. Be grateful. You have air to breathe. You're still alive. You're still eating, right? And you have a roof over your head, alhamdulillah. So yeah, so this is a time for us to look out for each other and help each other too. And you know, for those of them who are in need, this is the time for us to look out for them and take care for them. Take care of them. That's about more about humanity than about race or religion or whatever. Yeah? What were you saying?
The camera, maybe you want to put it there, because you know, if not, you'll see more of the roof.
Ceiling?
Oh, the ceiling, yeah. There you go. Isn't that better?
Is that better, guys?
Sing it.
Yeah, because this thing is not very stable.
Is it? It is better like this, I think. Then they'll see more of you instead of that ceiling.
Huh? Is that okay, guys?
Yes. Is that better, guys?
Yeah. Hi, Derek.
Okay.
It's Faizal Hamid here, buying. Thank you so much for being with us tonight. You know, I hope. I mean, you know, by looking at the viewers, it's becoming more and more. You know, so I guess you guys are enjoying this, can't even. All right, so let's go on with this. As I promised you, we're going to be playing more of the older songs. So this is going to be songs from the album. Pengemis Muda and Warna. Pengemis Muda pula. Demensi Baru and Warna. Yeah. Are you yawning, Daddy?
No.
Thank you. 1987. Oh my god, that was a long time ago, you know. I'm surprised I can still remember the lyrics. So I want to tell you a bit about my Pengemis Muda album cover. Do you all remember that? The one where I had a red cap and I looked like Santarina. Yes. I must tell you that we never had a photo session for that, you know. In fact, actually, that was taken from a magazine. I was actually doing a bit of photography modeling at that time. I was what, 17, and then they just took that photo and put it smack as my cover album to save cost, you know. Yeah, at that time it was a local company, but who cares about it, right? I mean, somebody was telling me that they liked my cover album for Kumohon, and someone was asking me, my god, you know that sheath of cloth that you had wrapped around you, is that like lamban? You know what it is? It's actually a curtain. Because when we went to the studio, and then you know, we were thinking of like doing something high fashion, apa lah, so we had the makeup done and everything done, but it just didn't look right for Kumohon, you know. Then so I said, you know what, let's just do something really simple. And then the art director was there, and then I don't know how we came up to wrap me in that curtain. There was a curtain in that studio, and we wrapped me up and we took the photo, and it was great. The mood was there. And there you go, that's my cover album wrapped in a langse, believe it or not. Yeah, so this is the thing, you got to be creative, you know. It's what you have and you make the best out of that. Yeah, okay. Alright, so now, how do you guys feel about the MCO? Some are not happy. I think it's okay, because you know why? At the end of the day, this thing is not over yet, guys.
I'm not really happy.
That thing, I know, you're not happy because you can't work.
Yeah.
So many people are also saying the same thing. But you see, this is the thing. If you can't work, if you go out to work and you're going to be infected, so you can't work anyway. And you know, economy all over the world, the economy has just stopped, halted. Everybody's not working. And like I said, everyone's going to go through the same problems, you know, and we're going to go through this together. We'll try and find a way. But one of the ways is for us to actually buy local and help our local economy. And hopefully, you know, the money will just spin there, you know, and it can help us a little bit until the whole world is healed. Yeah? So we just need to be patient, because as you know, at the end of the day, this thing happened. God knows how it happened. This is something that probably God wants to give us a wake-up call, like I said, you know, like, come on guys, you know, we are getting out of control. So putting us all locked down, we get to reflect, we get to introspect.
This today is like an extra lock,
okay.
So we don't have time for other songs.
No, of course we do.
So
okay. Are you kidding me?
No, I'm not.
We play the medleys. Okay, never mind. Let's play another medley.
Do you want to do your...
No, forget my news. We're going to sing. Do my what?
Your news, yeah.
No need. We don't have time.
I was ready with the theme song already.
No, wait. You said already 40 minutes, right?
No, I said it's 10:40. That means it's about...
How?
Nearly half an hour.
Right. So we're going to go on sing. We sing first.
Let's
do this one.
Alright.
We're doing all medleys because there's so many old songs that I want to do.
Pendirian sama anggaran.
I do my grocery run, I'm gonna get you some ginkgo.
Ginkgo biloba. Yep, that comes with age where you tend to forget a lot of stuff. Yeah, that's why nowadays.
How was it, guys?
A teleprompter. How was that?
Nice.
Did you enjoy those old songs?
Nice trip down memory lane, right?
Yeah. Yay, Patli, clap hands, Chandra love.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm glad you enjoyed that, guys. Okay, now. Do I have time to do my news really quickly? Yeah? Today's news. Suspend that. Alright. Selamat malam. Berita terkini hiburan sensasi. Alright, we'll keep it short. Today, total case 4,000. Not today, total case, yeah? 4,346 people being treated, 2,446 people discharged, 1,830 people. New cases today, 118.
Very good.
Recovered is more, 222
very
today.
Very good, very good. Alhamdulillah.
You know, so in fact, actually, and deaths altogether, we only have about 1.61%, which is 70 people, 3 new ones today. And even the ones that passed away today, you know, inna lillahi wa inna ilaihi raji'un, they all have underlying problems. They all have diabetes, or you know, there was one that had high blood pressure and also heart. Yeah, so that's the news for today. On the cases, and yeah, we have new news. Is that what you say? New news? No, latest. Okay, latest news.
Ready to come out with the case over there?
One time, okay.
Okay.
It's the same program.
It's a covering
day.
Yeah. Okay.
666 people got caught, guys.
For
just being out. You guys never
learn.
That's
666,000, right?
No, 666 people got
no,
caught.
No, times 1,000?
What are you looking at?
Yeah, 666 people. The fine is 1,000 ringgit, right?
Right.
Can you just give the donations to us instead of being caught?
Well, I haven't finished my news, Daddy.
Oh, sorry, sayang. Tak, bengang saya tengok. Nama itu nombor 6, apa hal?
Yeah, 666 people got caught. 392 got compounded, $1,000 each. 263 are still being remanded, yeah? So they are not playing the fool now. This is serious. We really want people to stay home. And anyway, why are you guys going out? What's out there? There's nothing open, you know? It's only the supermarkets, yeah? And if you want to talk to your friends, it's always the phone.
Don't be scared of staying home.
Yeah. So
don't be afraid.
So I'm just saying, it's more like you're just being... I mean, not victim. I mean, you're just opening yourselves up to being infected, yeah? And the other thing also I wanted to remind here is like those of you, when you come back from traveling and you're not feeling well, or even if you're feeling well, you know, but you just come back, just quarantine yourselves and don't go near anyone that you love or anyone that you know for at least 14 days, because you never know, you may be carrying that thing, yeah? And you don't want to be infecting other people. Like I said, we need to be the solution. You need to be responsible and stay away and be quarantined for a while until you're cleared after 14 days. Then you can go meet other people. And there's nothing to be ashamed of. Ah, this is that what I wanted to say.
Hey, yesterday you said
I already said it. I want to remind you guys again. There's nothing to be ashamed if you're infected with COVID-19. All right? You just need to go and get yourselves out there to the hospital, and they will take care of you, and they will make sure that they will give you whatever that you need to make you feel better. So the earlier you go, the better, because guys, if you're gonna go really late, trust me, that thing has already latched on you. It's manifesting in your body, it's growing. If you can see it, it's coming out of your nose and your eyes and your ears, but you can't see it. And when you feel ill, that means it's already bad. All right, so please remember that. And you know how I know all these things? Because I stay home and I got nothing to do. I eat lah. Okay? Alright, let's not waste any more time.
Yay!
What do we do? How long do we have?
Another 8 minutes.
Okay, let's do that. Medley. Right.
Okay.
You're gonna love this. Something fast. Well, mid.
Hilang yang ada ketika kau dengar. bangun setiap pagi, 6 hari seminggu pergi kerja. Tepat waktu 5, bukan baju kau tanpa pulang rumah. Malam minggu cuma datang, pergi ke disco atau nonton midnight. Esoknya kau siap lagi, roda hidup pun putar sekali lagi.
I don't know. Or is it all everyone here is above 40?
No lah. I know some very, very young ones here.
Really?
Yeah. A whole bunch of cousins.
Great. Thank you. I hope you enjoy all these Zaman Dinosaur songs, yeah? Like I promised, we're going to do something old. All right, Daddy, how long have we got? So
we have got 2 more minutes.
Oh my God, 2 more minutes. So anyway, we do one more song before we say goodbye, all right? Shall we just do this?
Me?
Yeah. This is a song that I really like. I did it once.
We were jamming.
And
it's still a jam.
So we're going to try and do this much better. Why do birds suddenly appear every time you move? Just like me, they long to be your eyes in blue. closing song for tonight, close to you. I hope you've enjoyed this session tonight. Yeah? So, till we meet again.
Tomorrow, what are we going to do?
Tomorrow, we'll probably
I thought you were going to play all your songs on it today.
Yeah, but that was the jam one, the last one. Okay. Yeah? So, anyway, we'll see you tomorrow. And tomorrow, we'll play our big hits. Alright? So, same time, 10:15. Don't forget to wash your hands. Stay safe. Stay home. Right? 10:15. Don't be late. See you. Bye.
Don't fight. Hug tight. Good night, guys. Assalamualaikum. Enjoy the rest of your night. And sorry about the MCO.